Hey kids, Darnell here, and I've got
DJ.
DJ's in here. DJ, what's one of your favorite parts of kids' church?
Singing and dancing.
Singing and dancing. So I say we do a little bit of that right now. How about you? Ready to sing and dance?
Yep.
Let's do it.
To all my people in the struggle, you think God's forgotten about you. Here's some pain medicine. Let's go. In your car, you at the house, on your job, be encouraged, boo. Come on! From a mighty long way. That's why we love you. Come on!
Chris, and I have a rap name too, which is C Swag, but I'm not a rapper. I don't know how to rap. Now, I had a question for you because, as you may have noticed, we're doing everything from home now, which means that all the things that we used to do outside, we are now doing it in our houses, and that can affect us in different ways. So my question for you was, are you more on the bored side at home? Or are you just, bored? Or are you very, very hyper, running all over the place? And I guess I'm asking you is, are you being lazy or are you being crazy? Here's a quiz to help you figure it out. Are you sleeping all day or are you playing all day? Are you mostly on the couch, watching a movie, playing video games, eating all the snacks? Or are you running through stuff, trying to break your bed, trying to clean everything, trying to get everything done, paint over here, art over here, things over there? Huh? Well, regardless of how you answer those questions, whether you're more on the lazy side, you know, you're just chilling, or if you're more on the crazy side, you kind of need to be right in the middle. Now, did you know that the Bible also talks about that? Did you think that I was going to bring up the Bible? Well, I'm serious. In the Bible, it does talk about being, you know, like overactive and being, which is a nice word to say, being hyper or being too busy, right? You know, sometimes it does more harm to be busy than it does to be good. Just like it does more harm to be lazy than it does to be good. Perfect example. In Luke chapter 10, it actually talks about how this one lady named Martha opened her house to Jesus, and kind of was doing the most. By that I mean she made sure everything in the house was clean. You know, she was running around trying to make sure everyone had enough to eat, trying to make sure everyone was comfortable, trying to make sure there was enough toilet paper in the house, things like that. She was just running around. Now, Martha had a sister named Mary. No, not Jesus's mom Mary. That's a different Mary. This is a different Mary. So Martha had a sister named Mary. And Mary was at the party too. And Martha, you know, probably was just walking around, and she looked over and she saw Jesus, you know, sitting there talking. But then she saw her sister, Mary, just chilling, watching Jesus talk, looking at his nostrils, looking at his eyes, right? Thinking about what he's saying. She's probably really interested in what he was saying. But do you think that Martha had a right to be angry? Well, I know that she did, and it says in Luke chapter 10 that Martha had a sister named Mary who sat at the Lord's feet listening to what he said. But Martha was distracted by all of the preparations that had to be made. She came to him and asked, "Lord, don't you care that my sister has left me to do the work by myself? Tell her to help me." What do you think Jesus said? If you want to know what Jesus said, because I'm not going to tell you what Jesus said, you need to go to this. Luke chapter 10, verse 41. Luke chapter 10, that's the big number. Verse 41, that's the little number, okay? And in that story, you can see what Jesus said to Martha. But I'm going to let you in on a little secret. He pretty much said she was doing a lot, that she needed to probably sit with Mary and listen to him just like Mary was. Now, what does this mean to us? This means that it's okay, and we have the right to think that maybe we can relax and sit back sometimes, especially now because, you know, we're at home with our families, and maybe you can spend more time with God. Wink, wink, wink. Now, what does the story of Martha have to do with us? Well, really, to me, it shows us that it is okay to sit back and relax sometimes if you're being extra, extra hyper. But that sometimes sitting and relaxing isn't necessarily called being lazy. Now, there is a difference. While you guys are home now, I do want to challenge you to make sure that you are still doing your work so you're not being lazy, but that you are also making sure that you're not being super hyper, okay? So we don't want you to be bored, and just lounging around the house all the time, but we do also don't want you to run around doing things all day. Here's something that I want you to take away with you. It's from Colossians, which if you were looking in the Bible, the abbreviation is C-O-L. So when you go to the table of contents, this is what you'd see. C-O-L for Colossians 3:23, chapter 3, verse 23. And it will tell you this: whatever you do, work at it with all your heart, as working for the Lord, not for human masters. So when you're doing your homework at home, or when you're doing your work at home, you're doing it to help for you. You're doing it for your parents. You're doing it for your teachers. But you're ultimately doing it for the Lord. Okay? So that's your crazy that you have to do. You have to do your work. But then after you do your work, maybe instead of being bored, you can spend your time doing things with your family and doing things for Jesus. Maybe. Okay? Now that's my challenge for you, is what will you make your best efforts this week? And how will you incorporate putting Jesus and having more time for him in your week? Bye, guys.